Yes, good morning, my dear students. welcome to online classes. Yesterday we have completed one chapter, that is surface chemistry. Today going to explain new chapter, that is called solutions. So it is one of the physical chemistry chapter. So it is very important. Generally solutions, in this chapter we have discussed some topics. Solutions, what is solute, what is solvent, types of solutions based on physical state, based on solvent, types of solutions. Next one, what are the solid solutions? Next one, what is the characteristics of solutions, and what is solubility of gases, of liquids, and colloidal properties, types of colloidal properties, and how to calculate molecular mass of solute. These are the topics you have to study under solutions. So what is solution? So what is the definition for solution? So solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components in which do not react with chemical. So that is called solution. So solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components or substance which are do not react chemically. Do not react with the chemical. Is called solution. For example, if you take 5 grams of salt or sugar. 5 grams of salt or sugar. So this is sugar. And you have to take 10 ml of or 100 ml of water. So this is 100 ml of water. This is 5 grams of salt. 5 grams of salt. This 5 grams of salt dissolved in 100 ml of water. 100 ml of water. Now it is what in state? Salts means what in state? Solid in state. Solid in state. Now 100 ml of water means what in state? Liquid in state. Liquid in state. After dissolving, what happens? The solid in state of salt dissolved in water, 100 ml of water, it gives what? Salt plus water, salt water, that is salt solution. It gives what? The resultant solution is called what? Salt solution or salt water. Salt solution or salt water. Salt water. Initially these are two components.
this is one component, this is another component. After mixing, after dissolving, it gives what? Salt solution or salt water. Right. Now this solution appears is like what? Water only, but it has two component. It has two component, but appears as again liquid. So this is called what? Means all components are uniform only. So the resultant solution is uniform. So that is called what? Homogeneous. So after mixing two or more component, the solutions again appears like one of the substance like solvent only, liquid only. So that is what homo. Homo means same, appears. Here solvent is liquid, dissolved by salt. Again they appears like what? Liquid only. But this liquid has two components, salt plus water. So these are chemically they are changes, but sorry, physically they are changes, but chemically not. Solids dissolved in water, the physical state of the salt only changes, but chemically do not change. Chemical do not react with each other. So that is the resultant solution is called what? Salt water. This is called homogeneous mixture. Now this is called what? Homogeneous mixture of how many components? It has two components. One is the solute, one is the what? Salt plus another one is what? Water. This is called what? Solution. So that is homogeneous mixture of two or more component or substance is called solution, but in which are do not react with chemically. Not react with chemical, right? So in this solution 5 grams of salt is dissolved. Now so out of this thing, which one is the less proportion? Now it is the less in proportion, less. This is what? Large proportion. This is what? Less proportion. Now we can say that the solution in which one has less quantity, which one has less quantity, that is called what? Solute. Now which one out of these two, which one is less quantity in solution? Salt is a less quantity, whereas solvent here water is what? Large in quantity. Now it is called less quantity is called solute, large quantity is called what? Solvent. Right. Now how to define solute? Solute, the solution in which the solution in which the lesser quantity substance or component is called solute. Example is what? So above reaction salt is a what? Solute. So that is salt is a what? Solute. Above reaction salt is a solute. Next, what is solvent? Solvent means the solution in which larger quantity or high quantity, which one is present, that is called what? Solvent. The solution in which larger quantity is called solvent. So example is what? In above reaction, here larger quantity which one is 100 ml of water. So above reaction water is a what? Solvent. Water is a solvent. So this is definition for solution. What is solute? What is solvent? So what is the definition for solution? Solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components, but in which the substance which do not react with the chemical, but physical changes are take place. So later I will explain that is characteristics of solutions. Right. So if you take 5 grams of salt is dissolved in water, 100 ml water, it gives us salt solution. The salt solution, that is nothing but solution which has two components, one is salt and another one is water. Salt here less proportion, that is why it is called solute. Water is a large quantity, that is why it is called what? Solvent. It is called solvent. Right. So this is the solute and solvent. When the solution which has only two components, is called binary solution. Bi means what? Two. So when two components are present in solution, these are called binary solution. When the solution is containing three component is called trinary. Yes, when the solution is containing two components, if the solution contains only two components is called binary solution. What is binary solution? Binary solution means in which the solution containing only two components, that is one solute and one solvent, that is called what? Binary solution. Example is what? Salt solution, sugar solution, all these are example for what? Binary solutions. Example, salt solution, that is sugar solution, benzene in toluene, these are the binary solutions. What is ternary solution? Ternary solution means what? The solution which containing more than two components. The solution which contains more than two components. Means not more than the solution is containing three components. The solution is containing three components is called ternary solution. The solution which containing more that is only three components, that is called what? Ternary solution. So example is alcohol or ethanoic acid in water. That is what? Solution of ethanol, ethanoic acid in water and water. That is solution of alcohol, ethanoic acid and water. These are containing three components. So this is called what? Ternary solution. What is binary? What is ternary? Binary means the solution which containing two components, that is called binary. Ternary means that is the solution which containing three components is called what? Ternary solutions. Right. So next one, what are the characteristics of solutions? It is very very important for objective purpose. Characteristics of solutions. Characteristics of solutions. If you observe, first one is, now solution is it homogeneous or heterogeneous? Solutions are homogeneous, whereas colloids are heterogeneous. So we are discussed about solution means. So just we have to talk about only solutions, not the first colloids. First one is solution is a homogeneous. Solution is a homogeneous. This is first property, characteristics. So when the solid particles means less quantity is what? Solid, which is present in which state? Solid state. Dissolved in water. Water is in which state? Liquid state. Solids are dissolved in water. Finally it appears what? Only solution only, means liquid only. That is what? Yes, physical state of the means the formation of solution, it is a physical state only, not in chemical state. So formation of solution, that is physical state only. So physical states only changes. Okay na? So formation of solutions. Formation of solutions in which physical state only changes. Solutions in which physical state only change but not chemical. But not chemical. Got it? So this is second part. Next one is, if solution is containing what? Solute plus a solvent. Solute plus solvent. So here, solute cannot be separated from solution by filtration. So homogeneous mixture. So homogeneous mixture means what? These are mostly they are what? Two solutions only. So in which the solute particles are substance. Solutes cannot be separate by filtration. By using filtration process, you cannot separate the solute particles from solution. So cannot separate from solution by filtration. Now your doubt is, filtration is not suitable method for separation of solute from solution, but which method is suitable? So distillation method is suitable for separation of the solute. So distillation is a method to separate what? Solute from solution. So means how to separate distillation means the solution is subjected into distillation. Now it is converted to vapor. That vapor is going to condensation. Then you have to convert into crystals. Then only you have to separate crystallization. Now this is one property. And one more is, if solute is non-volatile, when solvent is volatile, then you have to separate solute and solvent from solution by evaporation process. Your condition is, see, if solute is a non-volatile, so non-volatile means what? These are containing less evaporation, means these are compounds not converted to gas at existing temperature, means these are containing less evaporation property. These are called non-volatile. If solute is non-volatile and solvent is volatile, then separation of the solute and solvent in a solution, what method is powerful? Evaporation is a process. By using this process or distillation, evaporation or distillation, by using this this method we have to separate solute from solution. But here solute should be what? Non-volatile. Here solvent is a volatile. Then only you have to use this method, evaporate. Right. So this is the one of the property. Next one is, if solute is evaporation means what here? When the solution is undergoes distillation, now these particles are get evaporated. That evaporated solid particles now get condensation and you have to convert into crystallization. That is evaporation and distillation process. So these are the main characteristics of solutions. So here see, binary solution means the solution is containing two components, that is called binary solutions. Ternary means the solution is containing three components, that is called ternary. What are the characteristics of a solution means? First of all, solution is a homogeneous. Second one is formation of solution in which physical states only changes but not chemical. Right, next one, solute cannot be or can't be separated from solution by filtration. So this is a filtration, using filtration. When will you use filtration? When the solute is containing insoluble particles, but homogeneous means what? It is a solubility is more, means the solute particles completely soluble, means two solutions. So for two solutions you have to use evaporation and distillation, but impure means insoluble particles you have to use filtration. Already explained in surface chemistry. Okay, so filtration is you have to use for insoluble solid particles in a solution, right? But formation of homogeneous set is what? Two solutions. So now it is not suitable method for separation of solute from solution. Next one is, distillation is a method to separate solute from solution. So it is, distillation is a suitable that is method to separate solute. Next one is, if solute is a non-volatile and solvent is a volatile, what is the difference between non-volatile and volatile? These are containing less vapor pressure. Means the solution do not convert into gas at existing temperature. That is called non-volatile. Yes, solvent means is means what? They containing high vapor pressure. High vapor pressure means at normal temperature, at normal condition, these are easily converted into gases. These are called that is volatile. That is called volatile. Non-volatile, volatile. Volatile means the containing high vapor pressure, whereas non-volatile is containing less vapor pressure, because these are not converted to gases at existing conditions. Volatile means these are converted to gases. It means easily converted to vapor at normal conditions only. No need to apply high temperature pressure. Normal conditions only they are converted. So actually solvent, most of the solvents are mostly volatile in nature. Right. So these are the characteristics of solutions. Next one, types of solutions. So types of solutions means they are based on solvent. If the solution in which solvent is large quantity, so how to classify? Nature means physical state of the solute and solvent, how they are classified. So that is classification of solutions. Classification of solutions is very very important. Examples are very very important. Classification of solutions. Next one, types of solutions. Types of solutions. Now it is based on solvent. Based on solvent. Based on solvent. Means what? If the solution is containing more solvent, for example, aqueous solution. Aqueous solution. Aqua solution. Or aqueous solution. Aqueous solution. Aqueous solution means what? So aqueous solution means a solvent is water. Solvent is water means the solution in which solvent is water, that is called what? Aqueous solution. So here solvent is water. Solvent is water, that is called what? Aqueous solution. Non-aqueous solution. Non-aqueous solution. Non-aqueous solution means what? Solvent is other than water. Other than water. Solvent is other than water. Next one is alcoholic solutions or alcoholic solution. Alcoholic solution means what? The solution in which alcohol is what? Solvent. So here solvent is alcohol. Next one, ammonical solution. Ammonical solution means what? When liquid ammonia is solvent. So that is ammonical solution. So ammonical solution means what? When liquid ammonia is solvent. That is called ammonical solution. Liquid ammonia is a solvent. Now it is called what? Ammonical solution. So based on solvent, the solutions are classified into aqueous solutions, non-aqueous solutions, alcohol solution, ammonical solution. Aqueous solution means here water content is more. Means water is here act as solvent. That is called solvent is water. Non-aqueous solution is about solvent is other than water. Water is here less quantity. That is non-aqueous solution. Alcoholic solution is what? When alcohol is solvent, means alcohol is greater than water, that is called what? Alkali solution means solvent is alcohol. Ammonia solution, here liquid ammonia is a solvent. Liquid ammonia is greater than other. Now it is called what? Ammonia solution. These are the based on solvent. Right? So, types of solution, this is the one type of solutions. Next one, based on physical state of solute and solvent, how they are classified. So, let's see. Next one is classification of solutions based on physical state. Classification of solution based on physical state. Classification of solutions based on physical state. Based on physical state. Based on physical state. So here solutions are can be classified into three types based on physical state. One is solid solutions. Second one is liquid solutions. Third one is gaseous solutions. How many types? Solid solutions, liquid solutions, gaseous solutions. Again, solid solutions are again classified into three types. Here consider solid, solute, here solvent. Here solvent. So solutions are classified into three types. Those are what? Solid solutions, liquid solutions, gaseous solutions. Solid solutions are again classified into three types. One is, so solid solutions means a solid always in a solvent. So in solid solutions, solid is always in solvent only. Now we have to write the solvent, that is solvent is what? Solid. Three types, no? You have to write solid. So first one is when solute is solid and solvent is solid, means solid in solid solutions, liquid in liquid solutions, gas in gas solid solutions. Solid solutions are three types. What are they? Solid in solid solutions, liquid in solid solutions, gas in solid solutions. Here solid, the term always in what nature? Solvent in nature. Again you have to, liquid solutions again classified into three types. Here liquid is what? Solvent. Now you have to write what? Solid in liquid. Got my point? Next one. Liquid in liquid and gas in gas. Gas in liquid. Next one, gaseous solutions again classified in three types. So one is what? Solid in gas. Second one is liquid in gas. And what? Gas in gas. Solid in solid, liquid in liquid, or gas in gas. See, yeah, solid particles are different. They are exist in solid and liquid gases, but a solvent is same. For solid solutions, solvent is solid. For that is liquid solution, solvent is liquid. For gaseous solution, solvent is gas. But solidity is different. So now, what are the examples for this one? See, yeah, let's see. So these are the solids. Again, subclassified like this. Next, what are the example for solid solutions, liquid solutions, gaseous solutions? Yeah, solid in solid means one is the solute, one is the solvent. One is the less proportion, another one is large proportion. So that is called. So yeah, solids. One is the solid. One is solid state. Another one is solid. But here one solid is solute. Another one is solvent, right? So alloys, alloys means mixture of two solids. So here 22 carats of gold. Gold means they containing copper. Here copper is less proportion. Cu is less in proportion. There is gold in large proportion. But two are solid. Copper is a solid. Your gold is a solid. But your copper proportion is less. Gold is more. Means here. It is what? Solute. Now it is what? Solvent. Next one, liquid solid. Here sodium with mercury. When sodium is mercury, NaHg, that is called amalgam. Here sodium is Hg with what? Sodium. Hg with the sodium means here Hg. And Hg is mercury is a liquid state, sodium is a metal, solid in state, that is called amalgam. Gas in solid, occlusion of H2 over the palladium, means occlusion means covering of H2 with palladium, covering of H2 with the palladium. Next one, these are the examples for what? Solid solutions. In liquid solutions, solvent is liquid, remaining are solid. Solid in liquid. Solid is less proportion, liquid is large proportion. Can you say example? Sugar in water or salt in water, all these are example. Liquid in liquid. Liquid is less quantity, means one liquid is less, another liquid is more. Alcohol. Right. So that is alcohol plus water. Alcohol is less proportion, whereas water is less large proportion. Gas in liquid, that is example for soda water. Soda water means what? Soda water means what? Carbon dioxide with water, no. Carbon dioxide is less proportion. Water is what? Large in proportion. That is soda water. So mixture of carbon dioxide water. Sealed at under high pressure. Okay na? So these are the liquid solutions. Gaseous solutions. In solid, solute in state, whereas gas is solvent in state. The example is carbon in air or carbon particles in air. Carbon particles in air. Okay na? Or carbon in air. So carbon particles are less when compared to air. Air is large, so occupied throughout the atmosphere. So that is carbon particles in air. Liquid in gas. So moisture in air. Moisture means what? Water drops present in air. Water drops are less when compared to air. So that is moisture is here solute, here air is a solvent. Gas and gas, any two gases, the mixture of N2O2, the mixture of carbon dioxide, any two gases, right? So in atmosphere, that that is gas and gas, right? So tomorrow class we are going to explain solid solutions. So solid solution, how they are classified. Okay, na? So this is the classification of solutions. Exams are very very important, right? So keep remember. I hope you understand this today topic: solution definition, solute to solvent, right? What is binary? What is ternary solutions? What is solvent? What is solute? Next one is types of solutions based on solvent. And this is the types of solutions based on physical state. Tomorrow I'm going to explain. one more concept. Okay na? Same topic one. Okay na? Bye.